Hello, my name is Harry Powell, and I'm one of the cochlear implant surgeons here at Guy's and St Thomas's NHS Foundation Trust. I'm one of a team of five surgeons who may be looking after you or your child. In these short videos, I'm going to explain the cochlear implantation procedure and the risks. This is part of the consent process so that you will understand what the procedure involves prior to agreeing to it. By now, you may have been through the full assessment. This will have involved a number of appointments, and also we will have discussed you in our multidisciplinary team meeting. If as a team we think that cochlear implantation will be better for you than your conventional hearing aids, then we may be able to offer cochlear implantation as the next stage in your care. Before surgery, it is important that you or your child have a vaccination against meningitis. Because the cochlear is close to the brain, there's a very slightly increased risk of meningitis after the operation. To minimise this risk, we therefore ask that you have the vaccination prior to the surgery. We're going to give you two envelopes, one for the GP and one for yourselves, so that you have all the information. We ask that you make an appointment with your GP as soon as possible so that you can have the vaccination at least a week before the surgery. Before the operation, a pre-assessment will take place. This is an appointment for us to check your general health prior to the surgery. We may ask you to go for an appointment in the pre-assessment clinic here at St Thomas's after your consultation, or you'll have a separate appointment before the surgery. All our adult surgery takes place at Guy's, and almost all of our children's surgery takes place at the Evelina London Children's Hospital on the St Thomas's site. You will have a general anaesthetic for your operation. The anaesthetic doctors will look after you and put you off to sleep so that you're completely unaware and you don't feel any pain. It is important that you fast before the surgery, and we give you a letter with instructions as to when to stop eating and drinking. The operation can take anything from 1.5 to 3 hours for each side. Every patient is slightly different, and the anatomy varies from case to case. This means that sometimes it is more complex than others. The crucial thing to remember is that we will take the time it needs and carry out the operation in the safest possible way. You are looked after during the surgery by the anaesthetic team. This involves having a small tube placed through your mouth and into your windpipe so we can breathe for you while you're asleep. Sometimes after the operation, people get a sore throat for a few days. That's because of the breathing tube, and it will settle and there's nothing to worry about. There's a nerve that runs through your ear called the facial nerve. It supplies all of the muscles of the face on that side, the ones that enable you to close your eye, to smile, and to raise your eyebrow. We monitor this nerve during the operation. To do this, we have to put some tiny needles into the face, one at the corner of the mouth and one just above the eye. Afterwards, when we take these out, this can lead to some bruising, and that usually settles over a week or so. We then prepare the area behind your ear by shaving some of the hair. This is so that we can keep the area as sterile as possible. If you or your child are having two implants, then we try to make sure that they're as symmetrical as possible under the skin. We can't, however, guarantee that they'll be exactly the same on either side. In small children and babies, the skin and soft tissues are very thin, so the implant can look quite prominent behind the ear after the surgery. This is nothing to worry about, and it will just entirely settle as your child grows. That is the end of the first video. Now you can watch the next video, which explains more about the operation itself and what the procedure involves.